Yeah. Hello, we're live, we're live. Let me just check that all is well. Morning, Karen, because it is morning for you. Hi, Melly. Hi, Ali. And there's Craig. Hiya, Craig. How fantastic was Pip? Let me just get that straightened up for you. There we go. Cool. We're on and we're live. Yes, thank you so much to Pip for her amazing demo and chats and for letting me join in actually as well, because I saw what Pip was doing and really wanted to do something myself. And Pip said, well, why don't you do it with me? So, and see if we can raise more by doing a joint venture. So, absolutely. So Sheila's on, Lisa's on. Hi, guys. Oh, hi, Kylie. And Pip's on. Here we go. You're on. We're all on. We're all good. So when I last checked, we were on £970. So when Pip was originally doing this herself, she had a target of £500. And so we had a little chat and said, you know, we should put that up. So secretly, I think inside we both thought £1,000, but then we said, well, let's put £750. And now we're already on £970. So that is amazing. So it's just fabulous that by doing something that we both love doing and doing something that can make a difference, we can share what we do and then people can join in and feel like they've made a difference too as well. And hopefully we will inspire you to make some projects yourself as well. So who else is on? Oh, hi, Sheila. Hi, Hannah. You've just come from Pip and you want to see what I make. Well, that would be lovely. I'd love to share with you. Now, I have got a special guest here with me today, my lovely Craig. Now, I've never said this on YouTube before. My fiancé, Craig, is going to craft with us. So if you want to bring your chair, I've got you a space ready to craft. So I just thought it'd be nice to share and get Craig involved. Now, many of you know Craig from Thursday night when you watch our paper crafts and piano. So he's going to do some crafting with us today. Would you say you're a beginner crafter, Craig?
I'm a very beginner.
You're a very beginner. Not just a beginner, you're a very beginner.
Very beginner.
You've had a dabble before.
I have.
You've had a dabble, but not in... I don't think you've done anything really in the last year. Sort of the first year of lockdown, you did a bit more.
You did?
But yeah, so Craig's going to... We're going to craft together. So... Why didn't you know that? Didn't you know, Pip? Oh, so, well, you know, it was on Facebook. Hi from France. Hi, Fiona. So, yeah, we are going to be creating with the Celebrate Sunflowers stamp set. And I have chosen this to work in contrast with Pip, who was working with blue and yellow. I'm going to be working with Craig and using the sunflower stamps, which obviously the... which I didn't know this until... the situation has occurred. I didn't know that the sunflower was the national flower of the Ukraine. So we are going to be using this stamp set. And actually, it's quite really very, very coincidental, but this bundle is actually on offer as well this month. So yes, we did used to do crafting with Craig's on Sundays, actually. So it's like crafting with Craig's back almost.
Yeah.
Isn't it? So I've got your own glue there.
Fantastic.
You've got your own glue.
Right.
Now, if anybody remembers Craig, he does like his glue. You're a fan of the glue, aren't you?
I like the glue.
He likes the glue. So this is what we're going to be using. Okay. We've not got too much to work with today, so we're going to have to... have some extra ideas because Pip had so many images in her stamp set. But these are some cards that I've made using this stamp set. And I've, like Pip, I'm starting off with some simple designs, just using the sunflower images. I've not actually used any of the leaves. And then I have created a couple of gatefold cards as well, which I'm... Oh, we're on the big telly as well. We're everywhere today. So we're going to be doing some watercolouring. You've not done that before, I don't think.
Okay.
With the watercolour aqua, they're called water painters. So I've even brought you your own set of water painters. You've got your own
Amazing.
Little set there. Okay, so I've got two. Oh, we're on 980. We're on 980. So we are going to be doing some colouring in. Okay, do you like a little bit of colouring in?
I do. Yeah. But for a beginner like myself, how easy is it?
How easy is it?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to show you. I've already done some stamping for you. Unless, do you want to have a go? Do you want to do some stamping? Should we go right from beginning?
If you want, yeah.
Yeah, let's get you doing some stamping. So, we are going to be using the shimmer card today, shimmery white. Now, I don't know if you can see, I don't know if you can see, Craig. It under a certain light, it has a little bit of a shimmer to it. You'll just have to take my word for it.
Okay.
And what we're going to do is we're going to cut this down into, make it A5.
A5.
Yeah. So I'm going to cut that for you.
Why
A5? Because we could do it on an A4, but you are a beginner. So I'm going to make it a bit easier for you and we're going to do it from an A5.
All right.
All right. So you're going to get, that's going to be your worksheet. That's going to be your, oh, did you see that little shimmer then? You can just see it. Now, the reason why we're using this card is because it just, it takes the water a little bit better.
Okay.
Yeah, it absorbs it a little bit better.
Is it the same side?
Yeah, it's exactly the same on both sides. Now, this is a really good thing having beginners do crafting with you because they ask you questions that you wouldn't even think because we just presume everybody knows it, but you shouldn't presume.
Yeah.
So do you want to move yours in a little bit so we'll get you on the screen? Yeah, so we've sort of got both of us in. Yeah, right. What we're going to do is we're going to stamp this large sunflower. And I'm just going to show you from these. What's happened here is I've made like two cards. This started off as an A5 piece, yeah?
Yeah.
And I've made two cards just from doing one set of stamping, okay?
Amazing.
So what I'm going to do is I'll do it and then you can copy. Is that all right?
Okay.
Is that all right? Yeah. So we're going to take, and I want to explain, I'm going to take this opportunity to explain because a lot of people get mixed up with this. Pip says, yep, great questions. We like questions, don't we, Pip? People get mixed up what ink pads to use with what things because these are both black ink pads, yeah?
I noticed that's jet black.
And that's tuxedo black.
Yeah.
But that doesn't matter, really.
What, jet black in School Rock?
Jet black. Jack black.
Oh, Jack black, wasn't it?
So, the different, I'm going to explain, because they look quite similar. They're probably actually a similar mould of ink pad. So, a Stazon is what they call a solvent ink pad. It's actually got sort of alcohol in it.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a water-based ink, that's what I'm trying to say. It's an okay? A Memento is a water-based ink, okay? And we use these, we have to use them with opposites. So we're going to be using water and water-based inks to colour in. So we're using water, so we need to work with the opposite, which is the alcohol-based, So opposites attract,
Oh.
Were you just going to say just like me and you then? Yeah. I thought I'll say it first. And then with this one, if we want to use our stamping blend, you know those pens you love colouring in with?
Yeah.
They're alcohol, so then we use a water-based ink pad for those. So we use opposites. So that's just a little explanation of how that works, okay? Also, Karen, it's your birthday today. Oh, you might get a little birthday tune later then. Okay, so with this ink pad, it has a little cover. Because you've not really to leave it exposed because it can evaporate because it's got alcohol in it.
Okay.
So what we're going to do is, because it's a big stamp and a small ink pad, we're going to take the ink pad to the stamp.
Yeah.
You see, because it's smaller. And I'm going all the way around and I'm doing a little bit of a twist action. Okay. And what I'm going to do is, I'm going to line it up in the middle. So I'm going to check each side. It's sort of roughly in the middle and from the top to the bottom. I'm going to press down really hard and back up, and I've got that image. Okay?
All right.
So now it's your turn to do that. So I'll move over. I'm a bit too far over. You're the main stamper today.
I've never done this before. So?
So take it to the ink, to the stamps of it, and give it a twist. Yeah. Now, little top tip, but it's okay.
Okay.
I'll put the lid back on.
So I'm pressing lightly, gently.
You're going to press really firmly. You want to hold it. Keep your fingers on it. That's it. That's better. Down and make sure and press all around it. And get a good coverage,
I remember Sutty used to do that, didn't he?
Oh, that's beautiful. Look at that.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Okay. So we could put that to one side because we're only going to do one big sunflower. Then what we're going to do, we're going to use this smaller one. All right. And we are going to, because this stamp is more or less the same, it's smaller than that one, we can take this stamp to the ink.
All right.
Yeah. So I'm just going to do a tap and a twist. Yeah. And then I'm going to sort of fit one in there like that. Yeah.
Ooh, see what you're doing?
Do you see what I'm doing? Yeah. And I'm going to fit one in here like that. Don't mind if it goes on the tablecloth, I'll sort that out. And then I think I'll do another one sort of there. So they're sort of touching but not quite going over each other. And one a bit like that there. Yeah?
You're like a very confused owl, isn't it?
Okay. So we're just doing that. We're creating like a little centrepiece.
Centrepiece.
Oh, Pip says smashing. So you're stamping. No, are you doing it that way?
What way?
Taking the ink pad to the stamp, I did it the other way because it's smaller, it's easier.
Well, I'm a man.
Oh, you're a man, so you're doing it your own way. Okay.
So am I touching it or am I just...
You give it a good press down and then back up. Don't rock and roll it. Don't rock it and back up and then straight back up. Amazing. So see if you find it easier just tapping that on there that way.
This way, yeah?
Yeah. Hi, Jill. Yep, and then have another go down here, down and back up. Brilliant.
Okay.
And then let's do some more. Lovely.
Right, for the last one, I'm going to draw.
You can do it your way.
Well, because it's dark that one, that's light that one, isn't it?
Yeah.
So obviously those two don't get as much sun as that one, so, yeah.
All right, okay. Oh, Fiona says she's missed you when you're crafting. I told you we need to bring it back, bring you back.
Well, I enjoy it. There should be more men crafting though as well.
There we go. Okay, so we need to put this back on.
Okay. You can smell the apple, can't you?
It smells like almond essence.
It
you know, like when you bake. Yeah, it smells like when your grandma used to help you with Christmas cakes. It reminds me of me baking with my grandma.
We used to get that from Martin Spencer's.
Did you? Yeah. Right, okay. So, what we're going to do now is if you want to open up your little water painters.
All right.
I have prepped these for you. There's one that you don't need. You don't need that big one, but these two sort of small and medium ones. If you take one of the lids off, one.
Right. So which one?
Well, just have a look, because...
Okay. There we go.
Let's have a look. Right, what I'm going to do is take your hand, and then, like, have a practice at... Squeeze it. Is any water coming out yet?
What am I squeezing?
Squeeze at the on the top here where it says push.
So it didn't say squeeze, does it? It says push.
Well...
I'll push then.
Is any water coming out?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, can you feel it going? Right, yeah. Okay.
Oh, it's
okay.
Weird.
Okay, yeah? Right, so what we're going to do...
How come yours is white?
Because I used it with a white ink pad,
so
I've had to get rid of it. Okay, so we'll start with the soft suede. We'll start easy.
Soft suede.
Soft suede, Sheila wouldn't let her husband near his stamps. Okay, so these, you've probably mostly, Craig, seen me using these for inking up the images. What you can do is use this part.
All right.
Now, a lot of my ladies don't like having a mess there.
I saw Pip do it earlier.
Did you?
Yeah, she's really good when she did with the windows with the grey.
Oh, good. Very good. So you've been paying attention
as well.
Full marks. So what we do is we squeeze it like that, a bit like castanets, like that. And then we have all this ink here. We never put the brush in that bit.
Why not?
Because we don't want to mess that ink pad up. We don't want to like make it go all weird and funny. We don't want to put water in it.
How much does it cost?
£7.
Oh, I think you've got 7 good carrots. No problem, is it?
Okay, so what we're going to do... We're going to pop the water painter in here.
Right.
We'll start with the big one because we stamped it first and it's likely to have dried quicker. And then we're just going to, you can start, and as you go out, I'm just doing a circle.
Is he not squeezing, are you?
Not really, because it should have started
the
flow.
So if I just tip like that?
Yeah, so do a bit more, get a bit more on.
Then I'm just doing a coin, a certain circle, yeah?
Yeah. And then just go back.
Oh, I like that.
Yeah, you might want to get a bit more. It's
I feel like Bob Ross.
Bob Ross.
It's your world. It's your imagination. Your flowers.
Oh, Oh, Sheila wishes her husband would take an interest. You've got full marks for
I've always liked cards. I've always liked to buy cards. I think the cards are more important than the actual present, mate, because the message inside the card is more important. I've always thought that.
Hey, you're doing good there.
It's like painting by numbers.
It's quite therapeutic.
It's like about card making, though. It's very therapeutic.
I have to say, Pip, I had a bit of an emergency today because I didn't have a stays on Reinker at home, so I need to give a big shout out to Joyce, who lives 5 minutes from me. And my ink pad was fine, it hadn't dried out or anything, but I wasn't happy with the amount of ink in it. So I drove down to about 12 o'clock to collect a stays on refill. Thank you, Joyce, for loaning me it very much. And when I came back, Craig was still watching you, Pip, and he said, "This is very relaxing, didn't you?
Yeah, it was really good.
That's lovely. So what I would advise is, whilst we've got this brown ink pad open, we can do all the other ones. Yeah. So it's not difficult, this. You've not found that difficult, have you?
No, but...
So you can just chat when you're doing it.
Yeah, but I think for you guys who've done it for a long time, it comes natural, doesn't it, to you all?
Well, it'd be like you playing piano.
Well, I'm not sprinting at that.
Yeah, but I know, but it comes natural to you.
Yeah, because I'm a man. You know,
don't be getting too wet.
Now, when it comes to this, I mean, there are lads out there, I think, who do enjoy doing this. I mean, look at what's her name?
Sarah's husband.
He's really good.
Well, he's very creative with doing his graphic design and stuff.
Exactly. Very...
Did you see what Sarah did when it was Valentine's?
Oh, hang on.
And Sean. No, I'm not having this isn't to have a go.
Did you get a card?
No, they invited all the guys from the neighbourhood to Sarah and Sean's house.
Yeah.
And there were about 12 guys sat in their kitchen.
Oh, I did see that. Yeah,
I showed you. And they made Valentine cards for the wives and the partners, yeah.
Yeah, it's good that. Really good.
So we're just colouring. Hey, doing well there. It's lovely watching us craft together.
Yeah, well...
Well, we need to do it more, don't we?
Well, we've got three people now, haven't we? Three men on decorating pianos, so...
Yeah.
Spreading the word. I'd be interested to know, do you know you had one of your questions yesterday on Facebook?
When did my questions? Yeah.
I thought of another question just recently.
Oh, go on.
No, it's a serious question.
Is it serious?
It's a serious question.
Anything.
I'd like to know... Of all the Stampin' Up! People who do cards and make cards, how many people actually send the cards to people?
Well, that's the thing. There's a hashtag that says make a card, send a card.
Yeah, because I know we're going to do one for Grace, aren't we, for her birthday?
Yeah, well, we might. Why don't you send her one that you've made?
Could do.
I can put a name on it because I've got some letters with me.
Yeah.
I think you should send it and you could put, I made this, Grace. You could write that inside.
So these inks, are these the ones where it starts off dark and it goes lighter by itself?
No, that's your blends.
Yeah.
I can show you that. That's going to be one of my next things.
All right.
Okay. So Wendy said, if you crafted together, who would play piano? We'd have to do a separate. We'd have to do a separate thing. So yeah. Yep. Fiona says she sends cards. She got one made yesterday to send out tomorrow.
Brilliant.
So we've done with our soft suede.
All right, done, yeah.
Okay, so what we need to do then is grab a little bit of scrap paper, or you can use your hand, and just sort of like squeeze and get rid of the excess brown, because we don't need the brown again. Yeah, that's fine.
Clever, that.
That's good, yeah.
That's so clever, is that? I like that.
Oh, kitchen roll works well.
Is it?
Kitchen roll.
Is that why we never have any left?
No, we do have loads of.
Okay.
Right, okay, so now we're going to go with this.
We've hit 1,010, I think.
1,010, oh my goodness.
That's brilliant.
Okay, so I'm going to use a colour called Bumblebee.
Okay.
And this is actually retiring. Do you know what that means when things retire with Stampin' Up?
A transformer?
It means that we don't sell them anymore, basically. So these colours, this is from an in colour. And they just last 2 years. So this is the one that ends. Now, this could be quite vibrant. So what I would do is, obviously, we've just coloured those little circles in, and they were quite easy to do.
Using the same pen?
Yep, you can do. Now, what you can do is, you can do each petal individually like that. You can make some darker. But just I'm not going to... Just do it how you want to do it. Yeah?
Okay.
Just freestyle it.
It's your world. It's your imagination.
Just be aware that sometimes if you've got a lot of water, don't go quite up to the line of your image because it can. And the reason why I'm saying that is because I've just gone over the edge. This could take us a while. So do you think that if you've used the Stampin' Blends pens before, you have, haven't you?
Yeah.
Do you think this watercolouring's easier than those?
It is, but it's hard when you're going up to the lines.
Yeah. Do you feel a bit more like an artist doing this?
I feel like Bob Ross, yeah. I feel like a
Bob Ross.
Maybe Tony Hart, but yeah, definitely.
I'm guessing Julie's glad Craig doesn't look like Bob Ross. Yes, Belinda.
I think...
hey, man, look how many people we've got on.
We've got 46.
46?
I think the good thing with this, though, is it's, you can't make a mistake, can you?
Well, there is a bit of a saying, you know. There's no mistakes in crafting, just an opportunity to embellish.
I like that.
So it means you can cover stuff up if you go wrong.
Yeah, I like that. £1,000 grain it for a good cause, extremely good cause.
Well, it's amazing.
Brilliant is that.
It's so good. It does come together quite quick though, once you get...
Yeah, it's as if the paints know how to blend in. Come here.
You're doing really good there. That's amazing. Do you think it's relaxing?
It is very relaxing, yeah.
Yeah. Don't forget your cuppa.
Drunk it.
Have you had it? Oh.
Yeah. Aye.
That's what, when you're a crafter, you never finish a cuppa. Yeah, you always get a bit, sometimes I get a bit too involved, especially when I'm doing my coffee and card. I make myself a coffee and then I get crafting away and then I forget to drink it.
Oh, question for you, do you go from the outside in or the inside out?
I start usually in the middle and work my way out to the edge.
Yeah.
But that's a really good question. But you do what you feel as, you know. Let me look at comments. You're doing great, Craig, Lorraine says. Thank you.
Never knew the sunflower was a...
What I'm going to do is I'm going to get you some more ink there. No, I didn't know that.
That's nice. My favourite flowers is sunflower.
There we go. Just make that could be quite intense. Hey, that's nice technique there.
It's blending in, see?
Yeah. So Fiona goes from the inside to the outside, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. See, people are answering your questions now as well.
Oh. Knowledge sharing, it's all about knowledge share.
I've got a great little technique for you and I think you're going to love it. Yes, it would look different on watercolour paper. Probably, Fiona, yeah, yeah. This is the shimmer. Shimmer white.
Shimmer? We like football as well.
Okay, are you going to carry on the smaller ones?
Do you want me to?
Yep. Just be aware
of
where your leaves start, because we're going to do those in green. Yeah?
I see, right.
Do you see what I mean?
Yeah, good thinking.
Sometimes it's hard to differentiate if it's a leaf or a petal.
I'll leave well alone then.
You'll leaf well alone.
In my jokes. Good. So,
go on.
Who comes up with the ideas of these projects then? You get them from the Stampin' Up team, or do you get them from is it yourself?
Well, I think most...
And how do you come to these projects? How do you come to these?
Everybody has a bit of a crafter's block, and this is whether you're a Stampin' Up demonstrator or whether you're a customer. Everybody goes through. It'd be like for yourself, because you write your own music, yeah?
Yeah.
Sometimes you feel more creative than other times. yeah. things won't come to you. Yeah. And Pip touched on this actually earlier, because she was saying a lot of her customers said they've lost the mojo. Right. That's the word people tend to use for crafting.
So my next question would be then, how do you get the mojo back?
Well,
from your experience, and Pip as well, how have you got the mojo back?
Sometimes people like to have a little browse online.
Yeah.
But often that can lead to half an hour later, and then you don't feel like, you know, getting all your stuff out. It can suck you in looking online at stuff. Often what I do is I'll maybe look back at some of my older designs that I've done 4, 5, 6 years ago. Not even with the same set, with a different set, because you can recycle your ideas with different sets, and that might get.
Okay.
Or, like Pip said earlier, just actually get your stuff out and just craft, just make a basic card. Because what happens is, the more you do it, the more ideas you get. It's like on a Thursday night when we do paper crafts and piano. You'll say to me, oh, I don't know what I'm going to play tonight. And then you'll start one or two songs, and then it all starts.
Yeah, so simply, so basically, stop comparing yourself to other people and just
well, yeah, exactly.
Just
not to comparison is the thief of joy.
Yeah, because when I go to look at YouTube and look at other pianists who are really good, I think, oh, I'll never be that good. But we're all different, aren't we? We've all got different skills and talents.
Absolutely. I don't consider myself to be like a messy crafter, like grungy type. I don't know what you're going to say now. And I can feel you laughing at the side of me. What I mean by messy crafter is, I don't mean that I don't have a messy desk. Every crafter has a messy desk. I defy any crafter to not have a real mess after they've been crafting. What I mean is the style of my crafting. A lot of people do stuff with alcohol inks and distressing.
I thought you said a lot of people craft with alcohol.
Jill says we all underestimate ourselves.
Yeah.
Listen what Susa said. Craig, when my mojo has gone, I have a motivational chat with Julie.
There you go.
There we go. Oh, when Fiona's lost it, she watches me. Oh, Fiona, that's lovely. Thank you. Yes. It's very easy, as Wendy says, to fall down the Pinterest rabbit hole.
Yeah.
Hi, Tilly Crafts. Thank you for joining us. It's myself and Craig today crafting together. It did say just do first half hour, but we've already done half an hour. And we've not made a... No, no. Okay. Hey, I think folks will be disappointed if you stop. Right. I'm nearly done on mine. Are you? We need a little bit more, I think.
Yeah.
And also, right, you don't have to, like you there, that's a really lovely technique. You've not gone quite to the edge, and you've left a little bit of white, and that's really nice when you're colouring. Because it's good, a little bit of white space on the edge is good for the eye when you're looking at stuff, apparently. That's why I leave a little white edge around when I'm cutting things out. And then what you can do is once you've coloured, if you want to have some kind of difference in colour, you can go back over and just go over the line. Can you see the lines that Stampin' Up! Have designed?
Yeah.
So what I'm doing is I'm going back over those lines with a bit of darker, just to give it some dimension in colour.
So what happens if somebody did make mistakes? If I go over the edge, what would you suggest that were? So they go straight over there, say like that.
Well, we could cover it up with a little rhinestone, but don't do it on purpose.
No, people do, especially when they're learning and they make mistakes.
If that happens, you could readjust your design and you might cut that sunflower out and stick it on something. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Jill says we all underestimate ourselves. We do. Right, how are you doing with that?
Yeah, done.
Right, I'm going to get rid of that yellow. I've done it on my hand. I look a bit jaundiced now, unfortunately.
Right.
Okay, so I'm going to get rid of the yellow.
Okay.
Are you going to do that, or are you going to do it on your hand, or do you want the paper?
Paper, please. So, we squeeze?
Yeah. You don't have to go. Yeah, just get rid of it. There we go.
That's quality.
It'll be fine, because will be we're colouring in green and it's darker anyway. It's not as crucial.
Oh, like that, Tilly says, a butterfly fixes anything.
Yes, it does.
It's a great, I like that. It's a good idea, that.
Yeah. So, we're now going to work with Old Olive. And do you know that Old Olive is one of the...
That's her from the, on the buses, isn't it?
Yeah. She passed away recently.
Yeah, she did, unfortunately. Yeah.
She was great, though. There's only about three colours, I think. It might even be two colours. No, three.
Okay.
That when I first joined Stampin' Up, when it came to the UK in 2007... I think there's only three colours. Pip might correct me. Or Diane's Crafting Along that still remain in the catalogue now. It's Old Olive. Your favourite. What's your favourite colour?
Real Red.
Real Red. And Pumpkin Pie. I think they are the only three that still exist.
I actually had an idea this morning.
Oh, Wendy. Yes, we are going to be doing that in a minute.
You have a shirt, right? You have a shirt, the Stamp Up shirt. They have the template they use.
Right.
And you can put number 7 on the back. Ronaldo, number 7.
Oh,
and red, real red.
Ah, right, okay. We've moved on to football cards, haven't we? Right, so we're going to take some Old Olive. And what I like to do when I'm doing the leaves, Craig, is with a darker, I like to go down the spine of the leaf, you know, down the middle, right. And then let it come lighter to the edge. But to be honest, they're not very big leaves, so...
The Ukraine had one of the best centre-forwards or strikers ever in football.
Did
they? Andrei Shevchenko.
Oh.
He played for Marlin Chelsea, but he was a brilliant footballer. And it's so sad to see these guys now, especially the Klitschko brothers as well, defending their city against, you know, what's happening? You know, the sportsmen.
This green just makes them
so pop. Why have you chose Old Olive? Why not dark green?
Because I don't think I like... Old Olive is probably a go-to.
Right, okay.
It's a go-to... Well, if you look at the grass outside, it's quite Old Olive.
Need cutting.
It does, but it's too, yeah, it'd be too wet still, I think. You two are a fabulous duo and both so talented. Oh, I don't think Cherry Cobbler was from the beginning, but I will check that. I will check that, but I don't think it was.
See, yeah. If you notice that one there, I've missed a yellow out there, right? But I've got a bit of green in because it's a bit of overgrowth.
Okay, yeah. No problem. Think on. Yeah, think on.
Yeah. Don't get this at Clinton's, do you?
No. We've nearly got 50 people watching this, Craig.
Cool. Good. Right, there we go.
Okay. I'm done. Right, so you're done.
Oh, I'm happy with that.
We'll just have a couple of minutes just to sort of let it dry. And then we are gonna make what we'll do is if you put that to one side.
Right.
Yeah. And we'll create some card bases while we are... Now, so, which would you like? So,
what's the idea of card bases?
Right, well...
Why do we have them?
Because...
You're not Clinton, you just have the card design printed.
No, the card base, this is what we call the card base, the actual bit that opens. Right. That's called a card blank or a card base.
Just another question.
Okay,
well.
Right. Okay. So what we are about in Stampin' Up, if you ask anybody what they love the most about Stampin' Up...
Yeah.
Demos or customers, I think, if you said top three things, the top answer for most people would be the coordination.
Right.
Okay, because we take the thought away because... And what I mean by the coordination is we've just used Bumblebee ink. We also have Bumblebee card.
Right.
Yeah. We have Bumblebee ribbon.
Okay.
So we know it's been pre-designed to match.
Do you have a Bumblebee design? A bumblebee.
We do have a bumblebee stamps.
They think everything, don't they?
Yeah, so we have soft suede as well. Would you like, and I'll give you like an example, would you like a bumblebee card blank or would you like a soft suede or would you like one of each?
I'd like a bumblebee because the bumblebees are nice.
Right, so if you do... If you,
you know
go,
why? Because you're my honey.
If you go bumblebee... Oh my God. If you go bumblebee... Then I'll go soft suede.
All right.
Yep.
Deal.
Okay. Now, another tip. We are going to make A5, but what I do first, and I'm going to explain this, I've got a beginner's course, you know, starting in April. So this will be part of it anyway, the explanation. But what I do first is I do my scoring. So a score line is that line that goes down the middle that allows you to fold
it's
it.
Like
I'm scoring. I'm not scoring a goal.
Oh.
Okay, so I do the scoring first and then I cut it in half. But what I used to do
just
is...
Just across then.
I used to cut it. I used to cut it first.
All right.
But then I'd have to score two pieces. I'd have to put to so we go down at 10.5 and we score like that. And then I turn it round and then I cut it at 14.8. Okay. And then I've got two. I'll do yours for you.
Thank you very much.
You've got to make sure you take your cutter out of the way. We've all done that. We've all cut something when we've meant to score it. So then you have two card bases.
Yeah.
Oh, we need the trimmer. So, right, now what people ask me is which way do I fold it? Do I go outside in? Do I go...
Yeah.
So if you see, that's what we've just scored.
Yeah.
So we've made it into a valley because it dips. Yeah, does that make sense? Yeah.
It's a bit extreme, but go on.
Well, that is raised, so that's a mountain. Okay. So to fold it, we're going to make that valley into a mountain. Do you like that?
Yeah.
You're looking at me weird. What a double act, you never fail to cheer us up. Okay, so you've got two card bases now, Craigie.
Thank you.
And I've got two, and you're on Bumblebee, and I'm on Soft Suede. Okay. And now we're going to cut our card down. So this piece of card measured 21. Because I just know that that's the width. And I'm going to cut it down, and you're going to go, but I'm going to cut down the down the spine of it, like that,
yeah?
And I'm going to make it into two.
I like that.
Yeah, that's good. Now, this is too wide, because this is 10.5. It's the same width as our card blank, so I now need to cut half a centimetre off here. And then I need to just take probably a little bit off the top to trim it down, and a little bit off the bottom. It needs to be 14.3. I'm just... You'll think of questions while I do it. So I've cut it down, we've got that.
Okay.
So I'll just take some more, and then I'll do yours for you.
So is there a technique for these flowers cutting off? Is there a name for it? Is it by folding card or just a
half card? I'm not sure if there's a name for it. Just did it as a class a couple of years ago.
It's very effective.
It is effective. So we've got two now. We've got two for two cards. Yeah.
I like that.
You like that? Well, wait till you see what we're going to do. I'll do yours. Do you want me to do yours for you?
Yes, please.
So pop it in and do it at 10.5.
10.5.
Oh, we can see them. Now, this is really good. It's like you've done this sort of... On purpose, but not on purpose, right?
Okay.
I've put it in there at 10.5. Now, it is actually quite a chunk more to that side. Yeah, you're going to have about 2/3 and a third. But that doesn't matter because we might not take it from this side, if that makes sense.
All right.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to shove it up 0.5.
Because the card is A5 and because I've done it on the...
You've tried to get it middle, but... I can see there that gap there is a bit smaller.
Try.
This is not me having a go.
Do not.
Actually really good that you've done it like
this. Master, you said
that. So I'm going to...
Shelley's ankle.
We're going to do it like this.
Not like that.
Now, there is a reason why.
There's always a reason.
Pip didn't put greetings on hers, did she? She was going to decide what to do, I think.
Right.
We can put some on ours if you want to.
Okay. Looking good.
Right, so there are your cards. We've done all our cutting now. Okay. Let's move all that out of the way. Yes, mirror image, Anne says there could be mirror image cards.
Okay,
so now what we can do, we've got our card bases now and we've got our designs. Yeah? Okay, so you've got your bumblebees. So if you open that out like that.
Two for the price of one.
That should fit on.
Oh, gluing time.
Hang on, gluing time. Gluing time, we're going to do something else first. We're going to do another technique. Now... You might have it like that. You might decide to have it like that. You might decide to have your card that opens.
I've already decided.
Like that, and have your greeting. What have you decided?
I'm going like that.
You're going like that, right? So I want to show everybody. You're so eager with that glue, aren't you?
Come on.
Right, no, I need to show you something. Right. Can you see that little speckled effect on there?
Yeah, that's lovely.
Do you like it?
I love that.
Do you want to have a go at that? Let's do it. Right. I actually think we could do with a bit of kitchen roll. You don't fancy being assistant, please,
yes,
do you?
And getting some,
getting a few sheets of kitchen roll. We've still got 49 people on. Thank you so much. How are we doing for funds, Pip? Right.
So what are we at now? What's the total now?
I think we're on 10-10. Right.
10-10.
Okay. So if you have a piece and I have a piece, it's only just to be safe.
Okay.
Okay. So what we're going to do, if you put your project there and then you're going to take your water brush that you used, yeah?
Yeah.
Actually, and then you can get rid of your colour on the corner.
Get rid
of your green, yeah?
Yeah.
And we're going to take we're on 1020.
Oh, that's brilliant.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
We're going to take our soft suede.
Okay.
Yeah, so I'm squeezing it to get a bit more in here. Right, now you might want to have other practices. What I'm going to do is I'm going to squeeze in here and get it all like that, quite liquidy. And then I'm going to hold.
No way.
Right, I'm going to hold my water brush over my project. And I'm going to tap it and start. Oh, I'll take the lid off. It's starting now. Can you see? I'm getting.
Honestly, you're like the female Bob Ross, aren't you? You are.
Right, you might not be able to see it, but I'm getting a little speckle. You've got to keep.
Try this.
Yeah. So go back and then.
Right, so I'm going in.
Yeah.
So I'm guessing I need to put quite a lot on the brush, don't I? Yeah. Now, why can't you go like that?
Because you'll get a massive big blob, I think.
Right, okay. So we're doing tapping.
Yeah.
So what?
Right. Oh, can you see? Oh, you're good at that. Yeah. Do you like that?
Oh, I don't know.
You don't know? Well, you've got one with and one without, you see. Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, it's good. It's good. It's a good idea. Where are you tapping? Where do you tap?
I tap near the end. Squeeze a bit out. Squeeze a bit of water.
On there?
Yeah. Make sure your water's flowing. Or even on here. Look, I've got
I see. Left hand better.
Can I tell you where I first learnt this? Do you know who taught me this technique? And this is not a joke. Shelley Gardner herself.
Did you?
When I joined Stampin' Up in June 2008. I went 2 weeks after I joined. I went to like a Stampin' Up roadshow, and Shelley came to Leeds, to a hotel in Leeds, and it was all to get the Stampin' Up name out there. And she demoed, and she walked around and spoke to everybody that night.
Yeah,
she spoke to everybody, and she demoed this technique. This is Shelley's style. She likes doing this kind of thing. Oh, that's so cute, Karen.
Right. I like that.
Ah, Knight of Navy, so saffron. Are they all really, Belinda? Wow. Oh, well, I miss... But Cherry Cobbler wasn't one. Right, have you done that? Yep.
Yeah, I'm happy with that.
You're happy with that? Right. Okay, so I'm going to set that to one side. So you've got one with and one without.
All right.
Yeah?
Yeah, lovely.
Okay, so... now we've got space here to put a greeting on.
Right.
Yeah. So that's going to go on our project like that. But it's a little bit, probably a little bit wet now. Now, I think the sentiments in here are maybe not quite appropriate, apart from know that you are loved.
Yeah, I like that.
I think that's quite appropriate.
Definitely appropriate for Ukraine, definitely.
We're going to take that stamp. In fact, I've never used that one before. So I'm going to put the sticker on the back. And I think it'd be nice to have it in soft suede.
Oh, this is what I keep finding. Oh, no. We've got things to keep finding on
the
house.
No. You mean you mean the backs of the foam pads?
Yeah, yeah.
These.
Those. Yeah, then, yeah.
Well, you remember the funny story about that, don't you?
What's that?
Well, one travelled all the way to Cornwall, which I found quite amusing, and it was in the caravan at Cornwall. Then I found one on the floor in Santorini in our apartment, which was completely bizarre. Okay, so we need a smaller ink pad, I think. Not an ink pad, a block. So we're going to use this one, Know That You Are Loved. So because it's a small ink pad, and not ink pad stamp, getting on my words wrong today, we are going to take the stamp to the... We've done nearly an hour and we've made one card each. Okay.
Right.
So I'm only doing really light taps.
Okay.
Okay. And I'm probably just going to stamp it about here. Yeah?
All right.
Maybe I didn't ink that up enough, so I'll give it and ink it up a little bit more than me. Right, just check you've not got any around the edge. That's all right, but don't rock it and roll it when you stamp it. Oh, you! That was such a casual way of stamping, like one hand like that. Back up, brilliant, done. Okay, right, it's your favourite time.
Glue time.
Glue time.
Even better.
Now, do you remember what we do with the glue?
Yeah.
Less is more.
No way.
Great. You don't want it. You know, you don't want it seeping out of the sides. The glue.
Okay.
Okay. I don't know what we're doing with the cards, Tilly. I think what we're doing is I think Pip's sorting something out, so we're going to give them to people who come to the UK from the Ukraine.
Okay.
No, we don't. We need to have a little bit more glue than that. Oh, here he is with his glue drawings. There's quite a lot there, love.
Huh?
Yeah.
There.
Right, that's glueography. It's glue art.
Just meant to give me the blobs. Look at that. That's my next class. Show people how to glue properly. Glue with love.
Glue with love?
Yeah.
Right.
Yikes.
So make sure you've got... It needs to come over here a lot more. To the right. Yeah.
Give it a little touch. So you get to take your finger and just go like that around the sides.
Yeah.
Do you know why?
Yeah, go on.
Just adds a bit of touch to it.
Does it? Bit of love.
Bit of love to it, yeah.
And that?
There's a little bit there, stuck up there.
No, don't peel it.
There we go.
Lots and lots of glue, as Pip said. Fiona's cringing by the amount of glue you're using. I've got a card. Have you got a card?
Yeah.
Brilliant.
A question for you now.
Go on. You like your questions.
So you make a beautiful card.
Yes.
And you decide to send these beautiful cards to people.
Yeah.
How many people in the Stamping Up community and beyond...
Oh, God.
Right?
Go on.
Write their own verses in there.
Oh.
Like poetry or poems.
I don't know. I'll just do the crafts.
I could do it for you. We're on to a winner here, right? Send me your cards. I've 4,000 cards in the house. Yeah. I'll just write notes.
Write poems for people.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah?
Yeah. They're all saying you use a lot of glue.
No, it's glue schmoo, it's fine.
Okay, so we've made a card.
Remember that glue history, the glue problem we had in Germany, we couldn't get a lot of glue through?
Oh, yeah.
That's because of me.
So we've made a card.
Yeah. Yes.
So I'm going to show everybody
how... I think it'd be a good idea to send these cards to people who are in Ukraine or coming from Ukraine, definitely.
Cool. Brilliant. Well, I want to show you another technique now.
Okay.
Yeah, is that all right?
I'll just put it on.
Well, are you good for another 10 minutes?
Go on.
Okay. So what I've done is, and this you're gonna, I know you're gonna make a joke now. I've made a mask, right?
Okay.
Okay. And what I've mean is I've stamped the sunflower again on a piece of scrap paper.
Okay.
And what I'm going to do, I'm going to take my glue. I gave you the best glue. And I'm going to just pop a little bit on the back. Can you see? I've not used... Because I don't want it to be permanent.
There's no lubricants or anything.
It's only temporary. So okay. What I'm going to do, it's a bit messy, this, is I'm going to touch it with my finger and make it less sticky. So it's still sticky, but it's not permanent, yeah?
Okay.
And what I'm going to do, we want to do this on our other piece.
All
right. Right. And it's just a little extra technique. And I'm going to work out where it goes based on the there. I'm going to line it up with the one I've stamped already. Can you see what I'm doing?
Yeah.
I've stuck that on there, that mask.
Okay.
And I've lined it up. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that little sunflower. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm going to show you actually now what I'm trying to create. Right, this is a good example. Can you see here that that sunflower is just like floating in, do you know what I mean? Just okay. Seems to be hanging about on its own. It doesn't look really.
All right.
Yeah. What we're going to do is we're going to bring it together. Can you see that one?
Right.
It's sort of a bit behind that and it looks a bit more realistic.
Okay.
But how do you get only a partial sunflower? This is this technique. Right. So what I'm going to do is we're going to cover that dark sunflower.
Right.
And then we're going to stamp another one, but only part of it, yeah?
Okay.
Like that. Okay. We'll remove this. And then it's underneath.
I love that.
Do you see what I mean? It's clever.
I've got a question for the international viewers.
Yes.
How many people, you know, in America and around the world, actually their husbands get involved? Is it a British thing, or is it just that, you know, did they get involved as well? Because I know, as I said, we spoke about Sean getting involved, but do your significant other get involved?
I think it'll be less than 1%. Yeah.
Right.
So that's your mask there. I've put it on for you. Found the right way. Do you want to have a go at doing this?
Yeah.
Right, now one thing I will just say.
Go on then.
You need to keep away from these because we've not put a mask over those.
Okay.
So you don't want to overlap.
Right.
Can you see how I've just kept away from it there? Yeah. So there's your stamp.
Get me alcohol out.
Yeah.
I'll take the stamp to the pad this time.
Well done.
Yeah, I'm learning.
Oh, Maria's husband makes cards.
Oh, brilliant. That's great.
Right. Okay. Okay, but just avoid that other one.
So where's that part going?
Well, it depends. I've got the leaves coming out, but you want to... Some of it's going to be over here.
So, about there, yeah?
Yeah, if you want. Or you can... Do you want to turn it the other... Oh, yeah, that's fine. That's fine. You see what I mean? It'll just... Can you see? You've just got part of a sunflower there.
That's nice, that.
Right. And then all we have... It's just a little masking technique, you see? We're teaching people. And you can do it. You don't need any specialist equipment, just some scrap paper.
Okay.
Immense clocks in the craft room.
Fantastic.
That's good.
Yeah, that's brilliant.
So at least you're together doing something, which is nice. Right, we're now going to... We've now got to start colouring again.
Oh, colouring again?
But only one little one. And we've already got brown on from our splatters.
Yeah,
so we'll start on the brown. Because it means we don't have to clean it, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
There we go. So I've just done that. Oh, we're really quiet now.
I like that. I'm wearing that. Good.
And the yellow's up there, the bumblebee. So... Or using your kitchen roll. Oh, very good. Good boy.
Thank you, teacher. So.
Right. Oops. And then green.
So what's this kit we're using, the card?
This is a stamp set called Celebrate Sunflowers.
Is that because sunflowers have feelings as well?
Well, everything has feelings, I think, doesn't it?
It does, actually. Yeah. I'm a biology teacher on that.
Do you, are you wanting to do the ink splatters again, or...
No, not on this one. No, not on this one.
Right, foregoing that one and this one, okay.
My what?
Foregoing.
Nice word, that. Nice use the word foregoing, yeah, like that.
So that's just a little technique to show people...
Brilliant.
...how you can get a sneaky one, like on this one that I've done here. Now, another thing you can do, I can't because I've not got a big embossing machine at home. I've only got the mini one. But on this card that I've pre-done to give you an idea.
It did say they were out, not for sale at the minute. The
big one, yeah.
No, the small one.
No, the small one is. It's reduced this month, but it's the big one that's not available.
All right.
But what I've done with this is, as an extra element in your card design, once you've done all your stamping, all your ink flicking, all your colouring, you can then run it through the machine with an embossing folder. So can you see on that one what I've done? It's got a textured look to it.
Yeah.
It's nice. But we're not doing that. But
how many people have not tried this one before?
This stamp set?
Yeah, or this technique. I'd be interested to know.
Well, that'll be good, yeah. Masking or watercolouring.
Are we gluing?
We're gluing, but I think we'll stamp first, Craig. Stamp the sentiment, yeah?
All right. I think I'm going to go that way around.
Oh, you're going to do a tent fold, right?
What fold?
A tent fold.
Tent?
Yeah, so if your card stood up like that,
yeah,
it's like a tent. So we call it a tent fold.
So, is that a book fold?
Yeah, it is.
Eh?
It is. Eh? Oh, gosh. I chose well.
Tent fold, book fold, eh? I'm made for this, me. So I'm retiring from the piano doing this.
Right, well, you don't need it on there just for now for your stamping.
Let me glue in.
So it'd be nice up there, I think.
Would you?
Yeah,
that'd
I do.
Be nice in the middle.
All right, well, you do. It's your card.
Is it?
That's what I say to my ladies. It's your card.
Is it?
Oh, man. There we go.
Right, okay. So I'm taking the ink pad to the... No, I'm not taking the thing to the foot.
Fiona's done masking and watercolours, but not flicking the ink. You did press quite hard then. Just make sure there's no excess ink around the edge. There we go.
Right, then we're gluing, yep.
Yep.
Woo! Best part of the game, making gluing.
Oh.
Come on, glue.
The thing is, making these cards, we spent a lot of time doing the colouring at the beginning, but we've done it for both cards. So once you've made one, you make your second one quite quickly.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly.
If we hadn't done the masking, we'd have made it straight away and it'd have been really quick. Oh, well, I think we'll try and make it a regular thing, Paula.
There you go. Football goals.
Oh,
as if you're taking a corner.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, I've got a colour flag in.
Oh, man. Right.
Oh, my flag's running around. It's blowing that way, wind's blowing that way. Yeah.
Fiona says, does she need to look away? Oh, gosh. Craig, you've used about pounds worth of glue there.
Huh?
You've used about a pound's worth of glue.
Yeah, well, I like to stick together. God, that's an art piece, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Rembrandt, I look at that and go, oh, the football. The common man's game.
Right,
what am I gluing? Where am I putting?
Right, lower.
Lower? Where am I putting?
Oh, man.
Remember the touch. Thank you.
Jill says you need a player on the post.
What?
Jill says you need a player.
Oh, yeah, I do.
It's too late now.
Okay. Actually, just talking aside, actually, if you're putting too much glue like that, is there a danger of it coming through the card?
Maybe not. Sometimes you can see it bobbling a bit, you know, like
Right. Rippling
a bit, because it's a bit too...
Okay.
Yeah. So you've made two cards. So bring in your other card. That's what we do. We sort of bring in what we've done so far, and we share. This is what we've done so far. We've only done four cards between us, but we've done some techniques.
Yes.
We've done masking. We've done ink flicking. What's colouring?
We're a teaching organisation,
aren't we? Yeah, we're teaching today. And we're having a little bit of comedy, humour. Oh, hi from Germany. So, yeah, did you like that?
Actually, really, joking aside now, I really, really enjoyed that. I found
well, you've done really well there.
I found it really enjoyable. I think, you know, I like the idea of the card, know that you're loved. You know, especially with people coming here who, you know, from Ukraine, they are loved. And the amount of support they're getting from us is, or from people is tremendous.
It is. And we're very grateful. And we're very grateful for, oh, look at us on big telly. I turned round and saw my hands.
Yeah.
Right, so what I'm going to do now is I think I'm going to do some stamping blends. Do you fancy making a cup of tea, please?
All right, shall I go to the kitchen then?
Well, it makes a change. Do you need permission to go in my room?
I'd like to touch your room. Right, thank you.
No, is it... It is on sale. It also is in the UK as well, Karen. It's 20% off the bundle. But yeah, do you want to do some blends?
No, I'll go make a cup of tea.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I know where my place is.
No, yeah. You have done really well.
I've really enjoyed it.
You've done really well there, love.
Yeah.
Thank you for joining in.
Okay.
I feel a bit boring now.
Huh?
If I just do... Maybe you should do some more.
No, anyway.
Okay. Right, okay. So... That was the using the stays on ink with the watercolouring. And now I'm going to use the Memento ink pad with the blends. So I just maybe need to move over a little bit, actually. It's not the same, missing my sidekick. Anyway, let's grab the ink pad. Oops. Let's grab the stamp. And grab the Memento. Yes, thank you, Craig, for entertaining us. Very nice. I'm very proud of him. So what I'm going to do is... I'm going to stamp this. I'm going to try and get it in the middle. But it's a little bit harder when it's... A4 like that. I've stamped with Memento and I'm going to thank you love. I'm going to take my mask that I made earlier. I've not planned this. Oh, you've missed bringing back Craig. The shouting, bringing... Well, actually, I've got something you can do, actually, so that's fine. We'll get him back. I'm going to stamp all this, and then I might get you doing a bit of colouring to help me, if that's all right. Oh, hi, Marcy. So that's going to go there. I should have just left that on, actually. It was in the right place. That can go there. There's actually going to be a lot of colouring to do here. I'm just thinking on now the best way to do this. And then I'm going to grab the smaller stamp. I'm doing this a bit like a one sheet wonder type thing. I don't know how it's going to work out, but we'll see. Wrong actually. Oopsie. Oh, it's worked out all right actually. There we go. Okay. I'm just thinking of cutting this down, you see, and then going across there. But it's a lot to colour in, is this. But if I've got my assistant, we can do it together, you see. So I'm using Memento because I'm going to use the blends. You use opposites, opposite inks. I don't know what I'm doing, but we'll just go with it, eh? We'll go with it and see what it looks like. Right, let's leave it at that because that is a heck of a lot to colour in. So it does look a little bit messy, but I'm sure we can do something with it. Right, let's have a look. Yeah, it would have been easier to draw a line, Linda, but I always do things the difficult way. So I'm going to grab my colours, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my trimmer. And I'm actually going to work out what I think is going to look the best for these cards. Now, I did think about doing a slimline card, which I thought could be quite nice. So what I'm going to do, this is quite... Thank you so much, love. We need you back for some colouring if you want to. Okay. Okay, so what I've done is I've actually cut them down to make like slimline cards. And I'm really pleased with this one actually. Do you want to do some colouring? Or are you all right?
Okay.
All right. You're going to come back on and do some pianoing, aren't you, anyway? So, I'll colour these in with the stamping blends. Oh, I've got a little bit of a blobs there. Hang on. Let me just check the measurements on this one. That's okay, right. So, OK, Can you see it? I've cut it down and I've done it that way, and I'm now going to do a slimline card. So I'm going to take the, oh, that's Granny Apple Green, we don't want that. Old Olive, dark and light blends. So I'm going to start with the leaves this time, which shouldn't take long. And I'm just going to go down the spine with the Stampin' Blends with a darker Old Olive. So there's just those two there, two sets of leaves. Have we got any idea on the total, Pip? Please. Oh, we still got 46 on. So please do stay tuned in, because I'm until 3, aren't I? So about half past, just after half past, Craig's going to do some music for the last section. So we're going to make it a bit like a paper crafts and piano on a Thursday. And if you don't already watch our paper crafts and piano, then we're live every Thursday at 7:30 UK time. So I'm going to do the dark like that. In fact, it probably is easier to use a brush tip because it's quite a large surface. So I'm just going to do the centres with the dark soft suede. Just do a little bit there. And then come in with the light. Ah, oh, thank you. We're up to 1,030. Well done. I think when we chatted last week, we hoped that we never said to each other, but I think we sort of hoped that we could get 1,000. But I don't think we've ever thought we would. So that's amazing. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so that's with the blends so far. Yep, he is going to play in about 15-20 minutes, Linda. Do not fret. Now, just to let you know, we don't actually have a Bumblebee set of blends. So I'm going to be using Daffodil Delights. Don't think I've ever coloured this stamp with the blends. I think I've always done the watercolouring. So this is actually new for me. So I'm just going over the dark bits like that. And Stampin' Up! Really help us with the images that they do, because they put a lot of the shadowing on for us to colour over, like where the lines are. So I'll just show you that. Oh, Tilly, I'll get Pip to pop the link on for you in the chat. It's via a Just Giving page. I'm sure she'll add it in the chat for you. Or the link is actually also in the description of this video as well, Tilly. So you could go on there and then use that. That would be amazing. We'd be very, very grateful. Thank you. So I'm trying not to spend too much time going over that, but I'm just then going to go in with the pale one. Pull the ink out, give it to blend. Really pleased with that actually. Okay, looking good. For the smaller ones, I'd probably be best actually using the bullet end. So I'm using Daffodil Delight for the blends, stamping blends, soft suede. So I've just changed up the yellow colour from when we were doing the watercolouring. That's the only change because we don't do a bumblebee blend. Oh, 1040. Brilliant, brilliant. Thanks, Pip. Thanks, Pipster. Keep them coming. Well, Tilly Crafts is asking for the link as well. We need to decide, Pip, as well, when we're keeping the page open until, because if people are watching this on replay, it might be worth, if anybody's watching on replay. Oh, thanks. Thank you for your donation. It's much, much, much appreciated. And thank you for chatting along with us as well. We love it when people chat. Okay, that's looking nice. It's looking really nice, actually. I'm really pleased with that so far. I feel like it needs a bit of green there, so I might remedy that. Hope you've had some lunch now, Pip, after your sterling efforts earlier. Coming together now. You can always go and add a little bit more of the dark if you feel, and you can always go and add a bit more. You can't really take it away. The colour lifter does help somewhat with that. I'm just going in and adding a little bit more, a bit willy-nilly actually, just to add a bit more depth of colour there. Where did we meet, Jill? We mentioned this earlier. I think we knew of each other, because that happens a lot with stamping up. You sort of know of people and you've heard of people and you see people at various, well, we used to see people at various events. That's not been the case, obviously, for a good while. But yeah, you used to sort of then see people. But I think we were both at a meeting together when we got sort of talking properly, in a meeting we went to in Birmingham. think the first trip we were on together was 2016, though, which was the, I think I'm right in saying this, which was the med cruise, which I think was when we sort of got to know each other a little bit more then. And I took my lovely friend Sarah from Australia along with me as my guest. That was 6 years ago. So I'm just going to do the... Yeah, I've got a photo of us. I think we went for a meal actually together as well. I've got a photo of us various places. I feel like it needs a little bit of green up here, a little bit of the old olive. So I'm going to grab my memento and my stamp. And I'm going to try and do this. Let me just grab some scrap paper. I'm going to try and do this without copying. Oops, I nearly threw my stamp on it then. That would have been a disaster. I'll just see if I can get a little bit of green in here. Just feel like it needs a bit. There. Yes, we did. I was actually, we were watching the programme the other week and they were in Rome. I can't even remember. Was it a film? It was a film. I'm trying to think now. And Craig said, I've been in that restaurant. And I said, I think I have as well. Oh, it wasn't a film, it was a TV series. I think it was The Flight Attendant that we were watching. Yeah, it was definitely. It was The Flight Attendant. Okay, so I've just added that, just to add a little bit of green there. Okay. Now, can you see here the difference? I don't know. Let me just lift that up. It's where I went back in and added some more. Can you see the difference in the actual depth of colour? So I'm a fan of that, so I'm going to go back in and just quite sort of randomly dab a few bits of colour on here and here. And it will fade as it sort of dries in to the project. Right, I now need to have a look at doing a card base. I think I'm going to have a little bit of a border and then a bumblebee. So, what I'm going to do first is actually cut my base, and I'm going to cut this to 20. So it's going to be like a DL size, so I'm cutting it to 20 and then scoring it at 10. Like that. So we shall cut a bit of card. that's going to go on there like that, but I might want a little bit of a bigger border. I'm wondering. I'm just thinking. Actually, you know what's going to happen? I'm going to end up cutting this down and cutting off that little bit of green that I actually just added. Right, that's shorter, so I am going to make it bigger. So I'm going to do that 9. I'm going to do that 9.5. Just bear with me, I'm doing calculations. That needs to be 5. Let's check this out, make sure it's right. Okay, sorry about the quietness there. Just getting my measurements right. Let me look at your chats. Oh, this one, this is normal basic white, Tilly. Yeah, this is normal basic white. Okay, so that's gonna go on there like that. Yep. And then I'm going to stamp a nice greeting here. Okay, now I have got a little blob here, which I'm not so happy about, but we'll try and mask that off. And actually, what I'm going to use is I'm going to bring in one of my favourite stamp sets. And I'm going to stamp Hello Friend because I feel like that is appropriate for what we want. So I've got Hello Friend. I'll grab some blocks. And my soft suede ink pad. I loved, I need my mat for this actually, which I didn't get out because I thought I'd only be stamping with the sunflowers. Okay, so I'm going to grab that. Do you know, I've not even had my cup of tea yet. I'm going to grab that friend and it's going to cover over that blob that I've done, which is quite good. Hopefully. Like that there. And I'll just grab my cuppa. Oh. Oh, we're on 1060. Can we get 1010? Okay. So I've got friend there, and then I'm going to grab the bumblebee ink. I think it's nice to say hello, friend. Okay. So when you're stamping with one of these photopolymer stamps, you do need to have a mat underneath, which you can see I have got. So pleased with that, actually. Now I'm glad I brought that stamp, the biggest wish home, with me, because I thought the Hello Friend would be very useful. And that's going to go on there like that. What does Fiona said? Just showed hubby and he said, wow, well, that's really nice, Dav. Di, I don't know why my friend's husband's called Dav. I've just got you mixed up, Di. So I'm just going to stick that to the card base, no, the layer that I've cut. And then pop that on to the card base. Funny, Fiona. That's going to go on there. Wow, I'm loving the long, thin card. Slimline. Probably just got enough time to make one last card before we finish. So who would like a little bit of music? Would you like a little bit of music? Craig's offered to play for the last sort of 25 minutes, which is lovely. So if you don't already join us on a Thursday night, then this is a little taster session into what it's like on a Thursday night with us. So I will hand over to Craig. Fiona, it's from this stamp set. It's from the annual catalogue. Biggest wish. Craig, that was lovely, lovely, lovely. So for those of you who don't know our sort of little backstory about paper crafts and piano that we do every week, we've been doing it for 91 weeks now, and it started off purely sort of by accident, really. I was doing a coffee and card session at home and Craig was practicing piano upstairs. I didn't realise that customers could hear him playing. And then they started commenting, saying, oh, I love this song. And then we had an idea to bring our sort of talents together to help get people through lockdown and give them something to look forward to on a Thursday night. It also helped me to show the products and things like that. And 91 weeks later, we're still doing it. So, and we really enjoy doing it, and it is lovely to do something together. And if you don't already follow Craig's YouTube music channel, then there is a link in my description if you wanted to follow his music. Just thought it'd be a nice little way to round up the afternoon. Ah, that's lovely, Maria. Oh, that was really gorgeous. That was a piece of music called Symphony. was absolutely gorgeous. Very, very moving. Thanks, Craig. The white really makes it stand out. I was wondering whether to add my signature piece of... I've not used one bow yet today. I always have ribbon on cards. So we can see what it will be like with some ribbon. Oh, thanks. We really appreciate you watching us, Fiona. Thank you. That is very, very normal to see that. just one piece left. Thinking what I could do with that. How long have I got left? 2 minutes. See if I can finish this in 10 minutes. Absolutely lovely. That was Smile. Gorgeous piece of music. Oh, good question, Linda. Maybe we should. A hashtag or something, or we'll see. Maybe we could have the hashtag. I'll see what Pip says. Something like card makers for Ukraine or something. Let's see what Pip says, and then we can find them via Instagram or Facebook. I will admit, I thought, I don't know how this is going to work. I don't know if it's going to look right, but actually, it's come out okay. Yep, card makers for Ukraine. So if you use that hashtag, then we will find you. Sure, Chris, it's from, I know it's from On Her Majesty's Secret Service. It's Louis Armstrong. You're welcome, Sheila. Thank you for your lovely comments. It's been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure to be involved. Absolute pleasure. Thank you, though, for all your amazing donations. It's given us a boost and a buzz. So actually, I've made this card in about 5 minutes, I think. Okay, let's bring in the stamps again. Oh, thanks, Pip. Gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous. So I'm just going to finish my last card and then I'll get all the cards out that we've made and then we can say our thank yous and goodbyes. That has gone quick. That was for Karen, whose birthday it is today. Thank you, Karen, for always watching. Okay, so that's my last card done there. So I just did the same, just the same design, but rather than having a slim line at all, I just went for the normal A6 card. And that's from a piece of A4, that is what is left. I've not done bad actually there, because I wasn't sure how that was quite going to turn out, but it's turned out, they've turned out okay, haven't they, actually. So let's not forget the cards that Craig and I did together as well. I'll try and get all these on screen. Oh, thank you, Sheila. Oh, thanks, Kylie, you could have a nap. You'll have to join us on a Thursday, Kylie. Just about got them all on the screen for you. Oh, you're using your sunflowers. Oh, lovely. So yeah, these were made with the Celebrating Sunflowers stamp set. I've not done any die cutting today. I've just kept it simple with a few techniques for you, and a little bit of colouring. And obviously, I made these with Craig, and I'm really, really grateful. Have you finished all your music then? So I'm really, really grateful to Craig for joining us today. I'm just going to turn around. There we go. There we go. Oh, we're a bit bright with that. Let's turn that off. Let's turn that light off, because we still look a bit shiny. I think it's because we're in HD on my phone.
HD.
We look like we've got a shimmer going on.
Sunbeds.
Yeah, anyway, thank you so much for tuning in today. Thank you to Pip, my partner in crime today, for letting us join on her idea and partake in the lovely idea that she had. So thank you, Pip. You've been a pleasure to work alongside. Thank you, everybody, for your donations, for your kind donations. Please remember to use the hashtag CardMakersForUkraine if you want to share any of the makes that you have made along with us today. And we hope that you have found this. It wasn't for entertainment purposes, but of course we didn't just want to ask for your money, so we hope we've provided some entertainment and a little bit of company for an otherwise boring Sunday for you. So thank you for tuning in, and we will see you all very, very soon. Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye.